Instruments. This is Dr. Prashant Kalaskar, brings for you S-Prompts, a simplified solution for professionals, management practitioners, trainees and students. Friends, in this video series, we will be discussing important topics and multiple choice questions of the subject legal aspects of business. Each multiple choice question will have a related explanation for the correct answer, which will further help you to understand and clarify the theoretical concepts. So, let's begin with the multiple choice questions on legal aspects of business. So guys, let's begin with the multiple choice questions on the topic Negotiable Instrument Act 1882. So question number one is, as per the Negotiable Instrument Act 1882, the term negotiable means, and the right option is B, that is transferable. The negotiable term in Negotiable Instrument Act 1882 means the value in it which is transferable from one person to the another person. So the examples of Negotiable Instrument Act is a check. So whenever one person, that is the payer, gives money or wanted to give some money to another person, maybe the payee, right? So whatever is written onto it in terms of number, that is the value, rupees, which is transferable from the payer to the pay. So the Negotiable Instrument Act, the word negotiable means the value written in it will be transferable. Question number two, the term negotiable instrument is, the right option is option D, all of the above. The negotiable instrument is a written document. The check, we will write the name to which, to the person to which we have to make the payment, entitles a person to a sum of money which is transferable from one party, payer, who want to make the payment, to another party, payee, to whom we want to make the payment, by means of delivery or endorsement and delivery, which is described under section 13 of Negotiable Instrument Act. Question number three, which of the following is not the negotiable instrument? So the right answer is option A, currency note. So currency is a legal tender guaranteed by the government to transfer the value, but the negotiable instruments have to have the following characteristics. First, it should be a written document signed and stamped by the maker who is preparing that negotiable instrument. Second, it has a specific payee to whom the value is to be transferred. And the third characteristic is negotiable instruments requires the acceptance and endorsement. Question number four, in Negotiable Instrument Act, the promissory note is covered under which section? So the promissory note is covered under section 4. So the right option is option A. In Negotiable Instrument Act, the bill of exchange is covered under which section? And the right answer is option B, that is section 5. In Negotiable Instrument Act, the check is covered under which section? And here the check is covered under the section 6. So the right answer is option C. Question number 7. In Negotiable Instruments Act, the negotiable instrument which is transferable from one party to another by means of delivery or endorsement and delivery. So this is described under section 13. So the right answer is option D, section 13. Question number 8. Which of the followings are not the negotiable instrument as per the statute? Means which is not legally been endorsed as a negotiable instrument. And the right answer is option A, banker's note. Because we have already seen that promissory note, which is also called as pro note, bills of exchange and checks are the three negotiable instrument which are been accepted and defined as per the law, that is negotiable instrument statute. Whereas banker's note is a kind of negotiable instrument, but it is not been endorsed by the statute. Question number 9. Which of the followings are defined as the negotiable instrument by custom trade practice? Means these are not the negotiable instrument according to the Negotiable Instrument Act, but they are being used as a negotiable instrument in the practice. So here the right answer is option D, all of the above. That means banker's note, share certificate, share warrants, dividend warrants are another types of negotiable instruments which are being used in practice in the trades, in businesses, but they are not actually being covered under the Negotiable Instrument Act 1882. Question number 10. According to Negotiable Instrument Act, the promissory note is, and the right answer is option D, all of the above. Along with all the above conditions, that is, negotiable instrument promissory note is a written document and signed by the maker. It contains an unconditional undertaking and it gives an order to pay a certain sum of money only to the specific person or any person who is bearing, having, holding that negotiable instrument. So, other than above characteristics, the promissory note need to be have a revenue stamp pasted on it and a signature on across the registry stamp. Question number 11. The parties which are involved in the promissory note. So the right answer is answer A and answer B. That means the person who promises to pay money through the promissory note is called as the maker, who is also called as payer or the drawer. And the person to whom the money is to be paid or the money is to be received is called as the payee, or on whom it is drawn, it is called as a drawee. So there are two parties which are involved in the promissory note, that is the maker and the payee. And hence the right answer is option A and option B. Question number 12. As per the Negotiable Instrument Act, the promissory note may also contain the promise of delivery of things along with money. Things can be anything other than money. So whether it is true or false, then the right answer is option B, false. As per the Negotiable Instrument Act, the promissory note must be a legal tender, that is money of India. If the promissory note promises to pay something other than money, then it will not become a valid instrument. For example, if the promissory note contains, I promise to deliver 100 bags of wheat to B and rupees 50,000, then it will not become a valid promissory note. That means the promissory note should contain only the value, that is price, money, and that too in Indian currency. Question number 13. On promissory note, the date is required only if the due payment is after a specific date. So the right answer is option A, true. The promissory note not necessarily required to contain the date on which it is prepared, place where it is prepared, or the consideration of payable amount, etc. The date is required only if the due payment is after a specific date or etc. In some of the examples of promissory note, we can see that I promise to pay a dash amount of money to an XYZ person after 2 months of date of its preparation. So obviously after 2 months of a specific date, that means in such case the date is required to be mentioned on that promissory note. Question number 14. Promissory note prepared by. The right answer is the debtor. The promissory note is prepared by the payer in the consideration to make payment of a specific amount to the seller, and hence promissory note is prepared by a debtor, who can be a payer, maker, drawer, buyer of the goods, etc. Question number 15. When the payment is to be made immediately by means of bill of exchange, such bill is called as, and the right answer is option C, site bill. When a payment is to be made immediately by means of a bill of exchange, such bill is called as site bill. Question number 16. When the payment is to be made on a fixed date by means of bill of exchange, such bill is called as option A, term bill. Question number 17. Bill of exchange is prepared by, and the right answer is option A, the creditor. Bill of exchange is prepared by the seller after selling the goods to a particular buyer, mentioning the sum of money which is receivable to him from the buyer. Since the bill of exchange is prepared to ensure the money receivable, The maker of bill of exchange is called as the creditor, drawer, maker, or even he can be a seller. Question number 18. The payer of bill of exchange is also called as the acceptor. True or false? The right answer is option A, true. Since the buyer has to make payment against the goods purchased, he will be the payer. The bill of exchange is prepared by the seller to receive money against the goods sold, which the buyer needs to accept to make the payment to the seller, and hence he will also become the acceptor. Since B has to make a payment to S, seller, he will be also called as a drawee or the debtor. Question number 19. The person who is drawer of a bill of exchange is also a payee. True or false? And the right answer is option A, true. Since the bill of exchange is prepared by the seller of goods to receive money from the buyer, hence the drawer of bill of exchange will also become the payee who will be receiving the money. Sometimes the drawer of bill of exchange can also collect the money through his or her agent. Question number 20. There are three parties involved in bill of exchange. True or false? And the right answer is option A, true. In bill of exchange, there can be three parties. First, the maker, the drawer of bill of exchange, who is also the seller, who is supposed to receive money from his buyer. Second, the payer, who is a buyer who is supposed to make the payment to the seller against the goods received. And third could be the agent of the seller who can receive the money on behalf of the seller or maker of the bill of exchange. Question number 21. The difference between the promissory note and the check is, and the right answer is option E, all of the above. That means the check has a limited validity. The check can get expired after the 3 months from the date of its preparation. Checks are drawn on a specific bank, whereas promissory note need not to include any bank. Checks can be crossed for safety purpose, whereas promissory notes are not required to be crossed, and checks do not have any grace period after its expiry, whereas promissory note may have a grace period up to 3 days from the date of its expiry. So these are the major differential points between the promissory note and the check. Question number 22. Payment made by check can be countermanded. The right answer is option A, true. Payment by check can be countermanded, means it can be stopped or it can be cancelled by giving such instructions to the bank before actually making the payment by the drawer. While the other negotiable instruments like promissory note and bill of exchange cannot be countermanded. Question number 23. Payment through bearer checks are said to be the unsafe methods. And the right answer is option A, true. If a bearer check, that is a non-crossed check, is lost, the finder can encash it unless the bank is notified in time to stop the payment. The bearer check does not require any endorsement. If the bearer check is lost or payment is made to a wrong person, the bank has no responsibility for it. That's why it is said that the bearer check is not a safe method for payment. Question number 24. If the bearer check non-crossed is lost or payment is made to a wrong person, bank can be held responsible for it. The answer is option B, false. As we have discussed that if it is a bearer check and if it is lost and if the payment has been made to a wrong person by the bank, we cannot hold responsible bank for it. Hence, it is always advisable that whenever the payment is to be made by check, it should be crossed and a specific person's name must be included on it. Question number 25. The payment through order check is made only to the person named therein the check on the production of a valid identification, and the right answer is option A, that is true. Order check is prepared on the name of a specific person, and hence the same person can encash it in the bank by providing a valid identification card. That means it is a better option over the uncrossed bearer check to give a order check, wherein the name of a specific person is given, so that against the order check, if the bank has to make a payment, the bank required to see the valid identification of the person who want to encash that check. So in such case, if bank makes payment to a wrong person, we can held bank responsible. That's why it is advisable to give bearer check, sorry, to give an order check or give a check which will be a crossed check. Question number 26. Which of the following is the characteristics of negotiable instrument? The answer is option D, all of the above. That means the negotiable instruments are freely transferable. The title of the holder must be free from all the defects. Means neither there should be any mistake in the name or even the date or anything else which is written on the instrument. The title of the drawer must be also free from all the defects. Question number 27. Bill of exchange is drawn in parts are called as, and the right answer is option A, bills in set. Question number 28. Dash is a bill to which the document of title to the goods and other documents are attached, and the right answer is option C, documentary bill. Documents of title includes a bill of lading, dock warrant, dock receipt, warehouse receipt, and order for the delivery of goods, insurance of the goods, etc. Such bills are called as documentary bill. Question number 29. A negotiable instrument which is delivered conditionally or for the purpose of a collateral security or for the safe custody only and not for the purpose of transferring absolutely the property therein is called as. The right answer is option B, escrow. Escrow is a bond or a deed or other document kept in the custody of a third party and taking effect only when a specified condition has been fulfilled, so that the goods which are mentioned into the document can be transferred and that person will give the money to the person to whom it is supposed to be given. That's why to make it more secured, a conditional negotiable instrument can be prepared, which is called as escrow. Question number 30. On the face of check at the upper left corner, two parallel lines with or without written words as and company, such crossing is called as, and the right answer is option D, general crossing. So here you can see on the left uppermost corner of the check, there are two parallel lines are written and there is nothing mentioned in between these two lines. So such crossings is important because such crossing will ensure that the money will be transferred only to the person's account on whose name the check was been drawn. So such kind of a crossing is called as general crossing. Question number 31. On the face of check at the upper left corner, two parallel lines with banker's name and written words as not negotiable, if it is written, such crossing is called as, answer B, is called as special crossing. So here the same example, if we see that Nena Bank or Nena Bank and not negotiable, if something is mentioned in between these two parallel lines which are crossed check, then such crossing is called as a special crossing. That means such check can be negotiated only in that specific Nena Bank only. Question number 32. When the check is not transferred physically to the drawee's bank for the purpose of clearing, such checks are called as, answer is option A, truncated checks. Truncation means conversion of physical check or one form of check into another form. In this case, the physical check is converted into an electronic image which is then transferred to the drawee bank for the purpose of clearing. Such process is called as CTS, check truncation system. This allows to save the time and cost of sending the physical check for clearing purposes. Question number 33. In case of check as a negotiable instrument, the payers who prepares the check bank is called as the drawee. Drawee is the drawer's bank where he or she has his or her bank account, who will make the payment on account of the drawer. Question number 34. In case of check as a negotiable instrument, the payer who prepares the check to pay the dues is called as option A. Option is answer A, drawer, or option C, the payer. Both options are the right answer. Drawer is the person who is making the instrument for making the payment. That's why he is also called as payer. Question number 35. In case of check as a negotiable instrument, the person on whose name the check is drawn to pay all the dues is called as payee. So payee is the person who is entitled to receive the money. Question number 36. Which of the following is the reason for dishonor of check? And the right answer is option F, all of the above. That means if the check is ambiguous, uncertain, if the drawer has become insolvent, if there is an insufficient balance in the drawer's account, signature of the drawer is not matching with the specimen signature which is given in the bank, or if the check is been presented as a post-dated check before the mentioned date. So there could be some other reasons as well because of which the check can get dishonored. Question number 37. Which of the following is the reason for dishonor of check? So in continuation of the previous question, the remaining other reasons why the check will get dishonored are: the check is becoming stale, expired, that is after 3 months, holder has given a notice of loss of check, check is not presented in a normal banking hours, death of the payee is informed to the bank, the drawer has issued a notice to the bank to stop the payment. So these are the 12 reasons why a check can get dishonored. Question number 38. Payment to the negotiable instrument valid till a specific period until its maturity expiry. Such period is called as. Then the right answer is option C, that is payment in due course. So the person who is entitled to receive the amount mentioned in the negotiable instrument may receive the payment from the date of its preparation or from the day it becomes payable until the period of validity, or we can say maturity or expiry. Such period is called as the payment in due course, means not before and not after the valid date. Question number 39. A person who is entitled to possess the instrument in his own name and also entitled to receive the amount mentioned into it is called as the holder. As per the Section 8 of Negotiable Instrument Act, holder of legally approved negotiable instrument, that is check, bill of exchange or promissory note, is a person who is entitled to possess the instrument in his own name and is also entitled to receive the amount mentioned into it. Question number 40. As per the Section 8 of Negotiable Instrument Act, holder of any negotiable instrument has to satisfy which of the following conditions? And the right answer is all of the above. That means the holder of the negotiable instrument, to become the holder of a negotiable instrument, the one should have following conditions to be satisfied. First is, must be entitled to receive the amount mentioned into it, must have received the instrument in good faith, not under any kind of a coercion, must have a certain consideration, means if there is a buyer who is receiving the goods, he has to make the payment, so there is a consideration, and the instrument must be obtained in the due course of time. If all four conditions are been fulfilled, then such individual is called as a holder of a negotiable instrument. Brijesh issued a check on the name of Ajinkya against the goods received immediately after the receipt of goods. Ajinkya becomes the holder in due course. The answer is option A, true. We'll see now in example what we have seen in the last question. Ajinkya has become a holder in due course because he has satisfied all the following conditions. First, Ajinkya is entitled to receive the money because on that instrument Ajinkya's name is mentioned. So whether he is fulfilling the condition? Yes. Ajinkya received the instrument for the goods sold. So there is a consideration. So the answer is yes. Ajinkya received the instrument not by fraud or by theft. That means there is a good faith. So he is fulfilling the third condition. Yes. And lastly, Ajinkya received the instrument before the date of maturity. If it is yes, then Ajinkya is fulfilling all the four conditions to become a holder in due course. Question number 42. Brijesh issued a check on the name of Ajinkya as a loan or gift or under coercive action. Can Ajinkya become the holder in due course now? So here the option is B, false. Ajinkya to become a holder in due course, he must satisfy the following condition. Ajinkya is entitled to receive the money. Yes. Ajinkya received the instrument for the goods sold consideration. No, because it is as a gift or as a loan or under the coercion. So there is no consideration. So he is not fulfilling the second condition. Ajinkya received the instrument not by fraud or for the theft. Good faith. The answer is no. And lastly, is Ajinkya received the instrument before the date of maturity? Yes. That means even if one condition is not been fulfilled, then Ajinkya cannot become the holder in due course. Question number 43. The holder of negotiable instrument has to present the instrument for the purpose of receiving the claim, that is value for goods. And the right answer is option A, true. The holder of the negotiable instrument has to present the instrument for the purpose of receiving the claim, value or goods, called as presentment. The presentment of negotiable instrument is made for either acceptance purpose in case of bill of exchange and for the payment purpose, particularly in pronote and checks. Question number 44. When the negotiable instrument is presented or sent by the payee to the drawer payer for the purpose of payment or acceptance, it is called as option C, that is presentment. Presentment is simply a process of demanding by the holder of the negotiable instrument. That means presentment is required for the purpose of collecting the receivable money. Question number 45. Negotiable instrument is said to be negotiated when the transferee, that is payee, becomes holder of it. And the answer is option A, true. The claimant, that is the payee or presenter of the negotiable instrument, must get the claim what is mentioned in the negotiable instrument from the liable party, that is payer. Then only it is said to be negotiated, that is amount is transferred from the payer to the payee. Question number 46. The making, acceptance or endorsement of the negotiable instruments like check, bill of exchange, promissory note will be completed only by delivery of it from the maker to the acceptor. And the right answer is option A, true. Transferability is most important aspect of negotiability. Hence, unless the negotiable instrument is delivered to the payee by the payer, that is in case of pronote and check, or by the maker to the acceptor, that is bill of exchange, it cannot become a negotiable instrument. Question number 47. Presentment of negotiable instrument is time specific, and the right answer is yes, A, true. Every negotiable instrument is time specific and hence must be presented within the period of time of which the payment is in due course. For example, in promissory note, the mentioned amount is payable after 2 months of the date of its preparation. Suppose the promissory note is prepared on 26/10/2018, it means the payee can present the check after the 2 months of its making, that is 26/12/2018. The check is prepared on 26/10/2018, it must be presented before the 3 months from the date of its preparation, that is before 25th of January 2019. That means every negotiable instrument is a time specific. Question number 48. The negotiable instrument may be dishonored either by, and the right answer is option C, both A and B. So that means the negotiable instruments can be dishonored either by non-acceptance of negotiable instrument in case of bill of exchange and non-payment of mentioned value in case of promissory note and check. Question number 49. In such case of dishonor of bill of exchange, the drawer can go to the notary public in the court to file a complaint by requesting to note the fact of non-acceptance. It is called as, and the right answer is option A, noting. If the bill of exchange is not accepted by the payer, that is the buyer, for the purpose of payment of dues against the goods received, is called as dishonor of bill of exchange. The drawer of bill of exchange can go to the public notary to file a complaint against the defaulter party along with the facts. So the notary public has to write down all the facts onto the bill of exchange, the reasons behind the bill of exchange which has been not accepted for the payment by the buyer. So such process is called as noting. Question number 50. The process in which the notary public writes the facts of dishonor on the negotiable instrument and sign and seal it is called as, and the right answer is option B, noting. As discussed in previous question, notary public issues a certificate mentioning the case of dishonor of negotiable instrument along with the sign and seal of the notary public charging some fees. So such process is called as protest. So the right answer is option C, protest. After the noting process is done, before filing a case in the court, the payee whose negotiable instrument is dishonored must get a certificate from the public notary which contains all the facts related to dishonor of the negotiable instrument. This is called as protest. Question number 52. According to Thomas, a negotiable instrument recognized by custom or by law is, the right answer is option D, all of the above. So you can go through all the three options. You will get to know, according to Thomas, what is meant by negotiable instrument recognized by the custom or by the law. Question number 53. When a bill is drawn, accepted or endorsed without any considerations, it is called as, the right answer is option C, accommodation bill. Suppose Akash asked for rupees 2000 to Sagar as a loan. If Sagar lends rupees 2000 to Akash, Sagar can ask Akash to draw a bill on the name of Sagar, which he will accept. Later, Sagar would get the bill discounted from Akash's bank against the given loan amount, and such bill is called as a accommodation bill. Question number 54. If the bill is drawn on a fictitious name of a payer as well as pay, such bill is called as a fictitious bill, and the right answer is option A, true. Yes, it is a kind of fraud or dishonesty. Suppose a dishonest accountant prepares a check on the name of Mr. Balaji and intends his boss to sign the check saying that the business is owing to pay to Balaji. Boss was having no idea about any such case of or Balaji to whom the business is owing to pay some money. Such payee is called as in non-existing or a fictitious payee. Question number 55. When no bills are attached to the bill for acceptance or payable sent to the payer, such bill is called as a, option A, clean bill. When only a bill of exchange is sent for the acceptance to the payer, or a pronote or check is sent to the payer without any attached bills like invoice, insurance documents, etc., such bill is called as a clean bill. Question number 56. The negotiable instrument while writing becomes faulty. It is called as, answer B, ambiguous bill. Since negotiable instrument is a written document which is transferable from the one person to another person, it must be free from all types of writing errors in the title of the payer or payee. If there is any defect or fault while writing the negotiable instrument, it is called as ambiguous bill, and such bills will get rejected or dishonored. Question number 57. The negotiable instrument drafted on the name of any payee or bearer is incomplete in any respect is called as, and the right answer is option A, in-shout instrument. Suppose the party who is delivering a promissory note write all the details and sign it but forget to stamp it, or in case of check write the incomplete details of the payee, will be called as inshout, that is developing or immature instrument. Question number 58. The maturity of promissory note or bill of exchange is the date on which it falls to due, that is becomes payable. And the right answer is option A, true. The negotiable instrument must be payable either by demand or on specified day or after a specified date. The day or date on which the value in the negotiable instrument becomes due or payable is called as maturity. Question number 59. Which of the following are the instrument not entitled for the days of grace period? That is, no grace period is allowed. So here the right answer is option A, check. Check has a validity of 3 months from the date of its preparation, but is payable even on the date mentioned on it. Site bill is also the bill for immediate payment. On demand, pronote or bill is also payable immediately after its demand. Check expires in 3 months of its issue, which will not have any grace period. Question number 60. The promissory note is required to be presented for acceptance to its maker. And the right answer is B, false. The promissory note is prepared by the payer or the maker in consideration to the value received, and hence payee need not to present the promissory note to the maker for the purpose of its acceptance. Question number 61. The bill of exchange is required to be presented for the acceptance to the payer, that is the liable party. And here the right answer is option A, true. The bill of exchange is prepared by the seller or the payee who is supposed to receive the due payment from the buyer or the payer against the goods sold. Hence, it must be presented to the buyer, that is the liable party, for the purpose of its acceptance. Question number 62. Dishonor of negotiable instrument by non-payment is covered under the under which section of Negotiable Instrument Act? And the right answer is section 91. Dishonor of negotiable instrument by non-acceptance is covered under which section of Negotiable Instrument Act? And the right answer is option C, that is section 92. The promissory note can be dishonored by means of, and the right answer is option C, non-payment, which is covered under section 91. The promissory note is prepared by the payer or maker in consideration to the value received. Hence, if he fails to do the payment or denies to make the payment, it is called as dishonor of promissory note. Question number 65. The check can be dishonored by means of. Here the right answer is option C, that is non-payment, which is covered under section 91. The check is prepared by the payer or maker in consideration to the value received, and hence if he fails to do the payment or denies to make the payment, it is called as dishonor of check. Question number 66. The bill of exchange can be dishonored by means of. The right answer is option D, non-acceptance. The bill of exchange is prepared by the seller or a payee who is supposed to receive the due payment from the buyer, that is payer, against the goods sold. Hence, it is must to present the bill of exchange to the buyer, who is a liable party, for the purpose of its acceptance. If the buyer rejects or do not accept for the payment, it is called as dishonor by non-acceptance. Question number 67. The Negotiable Instrument Act 1881 came into force on, and the date is 1st of March 1882. The Negotiable Instrument Act was enacted on 9th of December 1881 and commenced on 1st of March 1882. Question number 68. The undertaking contained in a promissory note to pay a certain sum of money should be unconditional. The negotiable instrument must be freely transferable and unconditional from the maker to the bearer. That's why the right answer is option B, unconditional. Question number 69. A bill of exchange contains an, and the right answer is option A, unconditional order. The bill of exchange contains an unconditional order to pay a certain amount on agreed date, while the promissory note contains an unconditional promise to pay a certain sum of money on a certain date. Question number 70. The term a check in the electronic form is defined in the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881 under section 6 subsection A. The term negotiable instrument is defined in the Negotiable Instrument Act under section, and the right answer is option B, 13. Clearing house means a bank or house meant for clearing the negotiable instrument managed or recognized by Reserve Bank of India, and the right answer is option A, true. Question number 73. If an instrument may be construed either as a promissory note or a bill of exchange, it is option B, an ambiguous instrument. The meaning of the word construed means taken, seen or understood as a promissory note or bill of exchange, then it is an ambiguous instrument. Question number 74. If in an instrument the amount undertaken or ordered to be paid is stated differently in figures or in words, then the instrument is void due to uncertainty. The negotiable instrument must be freely transferable and unconditional from the maker to the bearer. So there should be no mistakes, no errors mentioned while writing on it. So if there is some errors or mistakes are seen, then we can say that the instrument is void due to uncertainty. Question number 75. Under section 16 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, endorsement in blank of an instrument means, the right answer is option B, where the endorser writes his name only on the instrument. Along with name and sign, if he adds a direction to pay the amount mentioned in the instrument to or the order of a specified person, the endorsement is said to be in full, and the person so specified is called as endorsee of the instrument. Question number 76. At sight, under the section 21 of the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881 means, the right answer is option A, on presentation. That means if the payment is to be made immediately on its presentation, it is called as a sight bill, or on a fixed date, it is called as a term bill. Question number 77. Can a drawer escape from his liability? And the right answer is option A, no. A drawer can never escape from his liability. The negotiable instrument must be freely transferable and unconditional from the maker to the bearer. Question number 78. Presentment for payment is to be made under the section 65 of the Act. The answer is option B, business or bank hours only. That means whenever a negotiable instrument is to be presented to the payer, then it must be presented during the business or the bank hours only. Question number 79. In determining reasonable time for the purpose of payment of a negotiable instrument, the right answer is option B, public holidays are excluded. In determining what is a reasonable time for presentment, for acceptance or payment, for giving notice of dishonor and for noting, regard shall be had to the nature of the instrument and the usual course of dealing with respect to similar instruments, and in calculating such time, public holidays shall be excluded. Question number 80. A notice of protest under section 102 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, the right answer is option A, may be given by the notary public who makes the protest. When a promissory note or a bill of exchange is required by law to be protested, notice of such protest must be given instead of notice of dishonor in the same manner and subject to the same conditions, but the notice may be given by the notary public who makes the protest. Question number 81. As per the Section 147 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, every offence punishable under the Act are compoundable. So right answer is option A, compoundable. Every offence punishable under the Act 147 shall be compoundable. The compoundable offences are those offences where the complainant enters into a compromise and agrees to have the charges dropped, withdraw against the accused. Question number 82. A protest is made by, and the right answer is notary. The holder of the negotiable instrument can go to the public notary in case of dishonor of a negotiable instrument. The notary public can do the noting and protesting for the holder. So these are some of the important questions on the topic Negotiable Instrument Act. For similar videos on multiple choice questions and on important subject, subscribe to my channel now. If you like the video, press the like button and share to your friends. Guys, all the very best. Do well and prepare well.